गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट इंटीग्रल ट्रांसफॉर्म नॉन एज द हेंकेल ट्रांसफॉर्म. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द हेंकेल ट्रांसफॉर्म, द वेरियस प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द हेंकेल ट्रांसफॉर्म एंड द हेंकेल ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ सम इम्पॉर्टेंट फंक्शंस. सो first we discuss about the Hankel transform. What is the Hankel transform? Let a function fx defined on positive values of x, then the Hankel transform of fx is defined and denoted by Hankel transform of the function fx is defined and denoted by Hankel transform of the function fx with respect to parameter p. This is denoted by f nu p or f of p. The Hankel transform of the function fx h nu fx p, that is the Hankel transform of the function fx with respect to parameter p, is equals to f nu p, or it can be written as fp, and this is equals to integral 0 to infinite x z nu px fx dx, where z nu px is the Bessel function of order p. H nu px or h nu fx with respect to p or f nu p is known as Hankel transform of fx of order. So the Hankel transform of a function fx of order nu, here nu is the order, which is the order of the Bessel function. So the order of the Hankel transform depends upon the order of the Bessel function. So h nu px, h nu fx with respect to p, that is we can write it as f nu p or fp, and this is defined by integral 0 to infinite x j nu px fx dx. Here x j nu px is the kernel of the Hankel transform. So Hankel transform of a function fx is defined by integral 0 to infinite x j nu px fx dx. Here the important Bessel function, one of the important function, special function, which is known as the Bessel function, is involved in the kernel of the function or kernel of the transform. So we will have to use, or we will have to remember some properties or some definitions or some relations of the basis function which are useful to find the Hankel transform. So first, the Hankel transform of a function fx, that is h nu fx with respect to the parameter p, the Hankel transform of the function fx of parameter of order nu is equals to integral 0 to infinite x j nu x px fx dx. Now before going to find the properties or discuss about the properties or the problems of the Hankel transform, we will remember some results of the Bessel function which are of important use in the Hankel transform. So these results are, we can find the results of the Hankel transform some important results of the Bessel function which are useful to find the Hankel transform of some functions. Rather, these results are the recurrence relations. Recurrence relation of the Hankel transform. These are some important recurrence relations of the Bessel function which are useful to find the Hankel transform. The first result is x d by dx of j nu x. X d by dx j nu x is equals to minus of j nu x plus x j nu minus 1 x. This result is useful if we convert j nu x into j nu and j nu minus 1. If we convert the Bessel function of order nu into the Bessel function of order nu and nu minus 1. The second result is x d by dx of j nu x. This is equals to nu j nu x minus x j nu plus 1 x. This is useful if we convert j nu x into j nu x and j nu plus 1 x. The third result is twice of j nu dash x is equals to j nu minus 1 x minus j nu plus 1 x. This result is useful if we convert j nu dash x into j nu minus 1 x and j nu plus 1 x. That is, if the order of the Bessel function is changed in the lower order and the upper order, then we will use this result. The result 4 is an important result which says that twice of nu j nu x is equals to x j nu minus 1 x plus j nu plus 1 into x. This is the result number 4. The result number 5 is, the fifth recurrence relation is d by dx of x raised to nu j nu x is equals to x raised to nu j nu minus 1 x. And the final result, the final recurrence result is d by dx of x raised to minus nu j nu x is equals to minus x raised to minus nu j nu plus 1 into x. So there are 6 results, some results of the Bessel function known as the recurrence relation of the Bessel functions, which are useful in calculating the Hankel transform on some functions. So we have to remember these recurrence relation. Now some other results also useful, which are the some integrals. We have to calculate the Hankel transform of some functions, and we know that the Hankel transform involves the Bessel function. So in order to calculate the Hankel transform, we will have some integrals involving the Bessel functions. These are the important integrals which are to be used to find the Hankel transform of some functions which involves the Bessel functions of order 1 or order 0 and some other orders. The first result is integral 0 to infinite e raised to minus ax j0 px. If the Bessel functions involves of the order 0, that is j0 px, then integral 0 to infinite e raised to minus ax j0 px dx is equals to a square plus b square raised to minus half, where a is positive. The second result is, when the kernel involves the j1, the first order Bessel function, and the integral is 0 to infinite e raised to minus ax j1 px dx upon x, and this is equals to a square plus b square raised to half minus a upon p. The third result is integral 0 to infinite x e raised to minus ax j0 px dx is equals to a into a square plus b square raised to minus 3 by 2. The fourth one is integral 0 to infinite x e raised to minus ax j1 px dx is equals to p into a square plus b square raised to minus 3 by 2. And the last result which is to be used is integral 0 to infinite e raised to minus ax j1 px dx is equals to 1 upon p minus a upon p into a square plus b square raised to half. So these are some important integrals which involves the Bessel functions, and these integrals can be used to find the Hankel transform of some important functions. Now we will discuss about some elementary properties of the Hankel transform. The first property is linearity property. It is very simple and it states that the Hankel transform of order nu of the function c1f1x plus c2f2x plus cnfnx. This says that this is equal to Hankel transform with respect to parameter p. And this says that this is equal to Hankel transform of c1 Hankel transform of f1x with respect to p plus c2 Hankel transform of f2x with respect to p plus cn hu the Hankel transform of fnx with respect to p. This is very simple. Directly if we put the results in the Hankel definition of the Hankel transform, we get this linearity property. The another property is the change of scale property. Change of scale property, which says that if f nu p is the Hankel transform of fx of order nu, then what is the Hankel transform of the function f of ax with respect to p? We will write this one later. So we find the Hankel transform of f of ax. If the Hankel transform of the fx of the function fx is given as f nu p, then what is the Hankel transform of the function f of ax with respect to parameter p? To find the Hankel transform of this function, we write the definition of the Hankel transform, and this is equals to h nu f of ax with respect to p f of ax with respect to p. By definition, this is equals to integral 0 to infinite x j nu px fx. Fx is f of ax dx. Now if you put it, ax is equals to t, that is x is equals to t upon a and dx is equals to 1 upon a dt, then this Hankel transform is equals to integral 0 to infinite x, that is t upon a, j nu px, that is p into t upon a, f of t, and dx is 1 upon a dt. So this can be written as 1 upon a square integral 0 to infinite t j nu p upon a into t f of t dt, or this can be written as this is equals to 1 upon a square integral 0 to infinite x j nu p upon a x f of x dx. If we compare this integral with the definition of the Hankel transform, we see that this is the Hankel transform of the function fx with the function fx with the parameter p upon a of order nu. So this is nothing but 1 upon a square Hankel transform of the function fx with respect to parameter p upon a, and this can be written as 1 upon a square f nu p upon a, which is known as the change of scale property. So this is the Hankel transform, basic results and some basic properties of the Hankel transform. Thank you very much.